I guess wanted posters in the future are actually some sort of hologram technology. Because this shit is the future. And I don't want to hear any shit about it from you Luddite-looking motherfucker. I have to use the word Luddite because I said in some other episode I said perennial when I meant to say penultimate. And I don't want to sound like a complete idiot all the time. Now let's look at this. This, I just feel like paper would be better, but I mean, honestly, what's the lifespan on anything Gotham PD in Neo-Gotham? I mean, like, what, 5-10 minutes before the bad guys get that shit? And then, but we see this. I'm very interested in this idea. We see our boy Terry. He's just wrapped up in barbed wire. I mean, if you start putting barbed wire on all the buildings on the outside, that's gonna make crime way lower. And you're like, Lindsay, how? Look, right now you gotta carry maybe one rug. Maybe you take the barbed wire hits, but if they start putting barbed wire on the outside of everything, I'm gonna have to start carrying around, what, 5-6 rugs? I got to go to, like, the Oriental rug store, and then I spend so much money on rugs, and I have to leave them behind, probably, because I'm literally making a getaway. Just the risk-reward of that, of whatever I have stolen, it's just, the gap is gonna be too huge, so you want to deter crime. You make people buy rugs. Now, I must say, I've kind of gotten over the fact that this guy's name is Terry, but I will not be swayed about people in my real life named Terry. Specifically, man, if you're a man named Terry, get the fuck out of here. I don't want your subscription. I don't want anything to do with you. Change your name. Become a man. Am I right? So, we start off on, I'm going to skip it, but in the previous issue, like, the very last page, there's a woman named Adeline who saw the Batman Beyond looking monster. She wakes up in her apartment, she's in a bit of a daze, but her future security system, named Move On, said that she was alone the whole time. What? A lot of stuff going on here, so. And then we finally get to our boy here, very beautiful, very graceful, very elegant. Not as elegant as Namor dying on a sword, but pretty close. It's like, even for Neo-Gotham, things have gotten weird. I mean, Neo-weird. Just be putting Neo in front of everything to remind us all that this is decades in the future, even. You remember Scab? He went crazy in the GCPD building. Had to deal with Commissioner Barbara Gordon. Shot up everything inside, but he acted like he was saving people from me. Called me a devil. Called me a monster. I mean, look at this face. Is this the face of the devil? No, but are those the horns of the devil? Quite possibly, I don't know. I need something easy to understand. It doesn't get any clearer than a street heist. Now, before I get into this, I just want to say, how did these lanes work? Whoa. How do ionosphere? That's not even right. What's the one before stratosphere? Whatever. This. How does this work? Because if it's working on trust, fuck no, not happening. So then we see. We got some Jokers down there. Yeah, that's actually Jokers with a Z, because it's the future. But, you know, 10 years ago, everybody's, you know, they were done with S's. We use Z's for everything. It comes back decades later in the future. We see they're just robbing a truck. Why do we also have regular roads? What is this crazy future? I feel like, and I'm going to use a colloquialism that's gonna turn the whole damn thing into a pun. Pick a lane. Are we doing future shit? Or are we doing regular roads? I don't know. This crazy world, I don't understand. But we see it's some Jokers. They need some behavior modification, which Terry, that sounds downright sinister. I can't say nefarious because I said nefarious like 8 times in the old man Hawkeye video. And we see this, and nothing is worse. Harley Quinn's pretty bad, but nothing is worse than a... This isn't... Like, I listened to How Did This Get Made, and whenever something is like something, but it isn't that, they say Bobo, so they'd be Bobo Harley Quinn, or just, like, ghetto, off-brand Harley Quinn, and she's got, like, an Earthworm Jim-looking gun, and he wants to know, you know, what's up, what happened up with Scab? He would've killed us, too. I mean... Yeah, just for outfit selection alone, he would have to. I feel like Scab was better dressed. Discord, I'm trying to, like, make millions of dollars here. But, of course, wannabe Harley Quinn is a terrible shot, but her name is Harlot, which, and, sweetheart, you got ketchup all over your mouth, and it's not even done in a pleasing manner. I mean, if you're gonna do clown makeup, do it right. That's what, John Wayne Gacy said, and we need to listen to him at all points. It ain't my fault, it's the monsters. So he's like, they all see him as a monster right now, and it's like, oh, you hurt his lady. And it's like, dude, take some pride in your goddamn makeup. I don't wear makeup. But if I did, I would make sure that shit is on point. Quote me on that one. So he throws some sort of grenade. Yeah, grenades? He throws it, but he hits it back at them. It explodes the truck. And he says, sometimes Terry's dialogue is like, kind of old-timey, so I don't know if he's doing it ironically or what. Okay, you crazy daisies. That seems like something I would hear if I just wandered in to a retirement home or something. Or like a hospice wing of a hospital. Like, oh, crazy daisies. I mean, and I can just wander in there. There's no security. Nobody gives a fuck about old people. If it's a monster you want, it's a monster you'll get. And then we cut back to Wayne Manor, and, if you recall last issue, Terry's little brother got to be Robin for a cool 15 minutes before he cut that shit back. And he's complaining to Bruce, and Bruce has some very long story, Matt. What's up? Don't ever say that, Bruce. What happened? Are you going senile? Are we watching a man just take a nosedive into senility right here? What's up? No. These aren't words you know. These aren't, I mean, you know what and you know up, but never the two shall meet for you, Bruce. I'm sorry. He's like, Terry says I can't be Robin anymore. Yeah, you didn't. Honestly, kid, you should still be Robin. I'm on your side on this one. But this whining, it's made me want to pull back and maybe reevaluate who I'm rooting for here. Terry isn't the problem. Batman is. He's the freak who made this call. Someone should do something about him. I hate to break it to you, but your brother is Batman. I know it's a whole thing, but he's Batman right now, so you gotta deal with it. So they go down to the Batcave, because if you're gonna talk about Batman, do it in his cave, I guess. And Bruce is like, look, you didn't follow orders. I mean, he fucked up in like half a second. He's a child, of course he's gonna fuck up. Who gave Batman a license to boss me around? Me, yeah. I mean, passing of the guard. He's seen a lot, has the experience. Terry does have your best interests at heart. Terry's fine. Like I keep saying, the real problem is Batman. And, you know, I guess this is a little kid saying Terry thinks he's got to live up to the mantle of Batman, so he's acting a little bit out of character, not treating his brother as his brother. But you got to keep in mind, the bad guys don't know you're related, so if he sees you cutting slack, somebody's going to make some connections, and then, kid, then you're fucking dead. I feel like statistically, though, if you're Robin, high. I mean, the turnover rate alone should make you reconsider this employment, but also, those motherfuckers die. Or they become a Nightwing. So, I mean, however you feel about Nightwing on that one. And then there's some scenes dealing with the blonde that he dealt with previous issue that he kissed. Doesn't really matter. They meet up with the Adeline, the woman who woke up in her partner. That shit don't matter, dog. And eventually, and if you remember from the previous issue, he has a girlfriend, sort of, named Dana, who walked up to Bruce Wayne's manor, or just Wayne Manor, and saw him kissing the blonde girl, and she wasn't having it. But I would also like to say, in Terry's defense, she was meeting up with him to say, hey, I don't like you being Batman. Stop. And it's like, whoa, whoa, whoa. Lady, I was doing this Batman shit before you were around, so you got to deal with me. So, of course, he does what any good Batman would do. He breaks into her apartment. I just gotta skip a couple pages, but he's like, look, he says, look, I know you don't like me doing this, but, he says it here. I know you don't like me coming in that way, but we need to talk. And how many glasses does she break every time he does this? She's like, who else would it be, breaking up, because I'm Batman and all. the way I see it, you broke up with me. I saw you at Wayne Manor kissing that blonde in your driveway. Not good. I gotta respect that reaction. True. You're awful. You're awful, in fact. You're a demon, a hideous monster. And this shit, this is what keeps me... I've gotta get the next issue. This shit is fucking cool. But I do want to bring up, look. You got a Batman. He's broken into your apartment. Keep your cool. You don't want to be making accusations about him. Who, whatever bitches he's kissed, it doesn't matter. Okay? Number one. Look, he's got these forearm projections. Plus, he has thousands, if not millions, of throwables, projectiles. He can just end your fucking life. So maybe keep a cool head when there's a Batman in the apartment. I don't know. I feel like it's good advice for everyone if I just point that out. And then, yeah, she sees this. So there's something going on in Neo-Gotham, like a chemical or something. Or maybe something to do with, like, his pheromones, because it kind of only happens when he's around, so there's something there. Something's going on, and I'm into it. So, of course, he just has to get the fuck out of there, because this bitch, she's calling the police. She's screaming, you gotta get out of there. You gotta get out of there, even though you could kill her. You could end her life so easily. So he gets out of there, but then he sees this whole thing going on, and I gotta say, are there any Batman statues? I know, what is it, in Kansas or wherever they do that Superman festival, they have Superman statues. Are there any Batman statues? Because that shit would be dope. And he's like, it's like the world's gone crazy against Batman. This statue represents the heinous. So I guess maybe it's anything that looks like Batman triggers people to see, like, a hideous monster. And a hideous monster statue, how do you kill it? It's not alive. It's got no organs. It's got no blood. What? A demon, a stealer of souls. Kill, 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 kill. It's a statue, but you know what? You're welcome to try. Live your damn dreams. So, everybody's there. We got jokers. We got regular people. Just people being like, what's going on? Statue's evil? I'm in. It's Friday night. I got nothing. So he sees this little kid, and look, he realized people, it's got that mob mentality. You need slag the devil. I don't know what that means, but it doesn't sound good. So I don't think this kid was any real danger. I feel like he just wanted to touch a kid. But then again, we got some crazies. This off brand Harley Quinn's got a flamethrower, and you know what? Be alert. Be vigilant when there are flamethrowers around. He saves the kid and he just hands it back to the dad, and he's like, that freak tried to take my child. Shoot him out of the sky. I mean, I guess you got to. Also, this statue, I think it's concrete. And I don't know if flames will melt concrete, because look, my barometer is jet fuel. We know jet fuel can't melt steel beams, so will fire melt a concrete statue? I don't know. That's a question for science. I don't have that answer. So the Jokers, they start shooting him. He doesn't understand what's going on. He's still trying to protect the crowd. I forget he's bulletproof. So that's good. And then he calls them dregs, which that seems like some 1950 shit to me. And they're shooting him with, oh yeah, I guess he's also flame resistant. Like, yeah, why wouldn't he be? He kind of seems like he's 1950s Batman and that he's got all the solutions. I mean, we've only seen Bulletproof, and I'm making, like, huge jumps in logic. But yeah, you Adam West Batman, dog. And people, they just start swarming him, beating him down. Oh God. He's going down. But then luckily, question mark, the police show up. It's Commissioner Barbara Gordon. He's like, oh, thank fucking God, these people are bananas. But oh no. She tells him to get the civilians out of the line of fire. Burn it. But then this is blue. I feel like it should be red. I'm into this. I don't know about melting the statue with a flamethrower, but I'm definitely going to get the second issue. I'm coming around, Terry. Still not real people named Terry. Not at all. But this guy. How does his mouth work? I still understand the mouth and the suit. So many questions.